अभी पॉज कर दे रिकॉर्डिंग. वेरी गुड. वी कैन डिफाइन करंट लाइक इन द स्मॉलेस्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ करंट इज रेट ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ चार्ज कॉल्ड करंट. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर रेट ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ चार्ज इज कॉल्ड करंट एंड we represent current by capital I or small I. Its unit is ampere. Ampere was a great scientist. Its unit is ampere. And mathematically we can say average current is equal to delta Q by delta T, or else we can say charge flown divided by time taken. So current basically is a defined term, okay? And this is how we can write average current. We can write instantaneous current also. If you differentiate charge with respect to time, you can write instantaneous current. dq by dt gives you instantaneous current. Okay, any doubt in this? This is mathematical formula of current unit. How do we represent current? What is definition of current? Any doubt in this till now?
No, sir.
Okay. We assume flow of current along flow of positive charge. Always remember, we assume flow of current along flow of positive charge. We assume flow of current along flow of positive charge, and current always flows from higher potential to lower potential. Always remember this. Current always flows from higher potential to lower potential. We assume flow of current along flow of positive charge. Okay. Suppose, bacho, if negative charge is going like this, so where current is going? Where current is going, left or right?
Left.
No, current will be going right.
Right.
Hai na? So current flows along positive charge and opposite to negative charge. Always remember, current flows opposite to negative charge. Okay, and along flow of positive charge. Any doubt on that? And current always flows from higher potential to lower potential. Like if you connect to water tank, then water will flow. Suppose this is water tank one, and you connected this with another water tank like this. ब्लू है पानी पानी, यू ऑल नो दैट. सो वाटर विल स्टार्ट फ्लोइंग, सॉरी, water will be flowing from higher level to lower level, isn't it? Water will flow from left tank to right tank because left tank has more water, right? Like in this diagram, it is very clear that water is going to flow from left tank to right tank. In the same way, current is going to flow from higher potential to lower potential. okay? Do you remember this? Like from this diagram, you can understand, okay? Now let's understand various type of current, okay? Different types of current. We'll understand different type of current by numerical example. Okay, let's talk about first type due to translatory motion of charge. Let's understand first type of current due to translatory motion of charge. Current due to translatory motion of charge. Question one. Suppose in a vacuum tube, at 5 kilovolt, (10⁻⁹) electrons are moving from cathode to anode in 10 milliseconds. Find current. Can you find current, bacho? There is a vacuum tube. There is how much?
1 ampere.
No, not one. See, according to formula, what is current? Now, current is I is equal to charge flown by time taken, right? And we from electrostatic, we can say that Q is equal to Ne, where N is number of electron and E is electron. And time is already given in the question. So what is N? Can you tell me what is N?
(10⁻⁹).
And what is charge in 1 electron? 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. And time is 10 milliseconds. 10 × 10⁻³. Okay, now you solve this, you'll get current. You solve this, how much will you get?
10⁻⁸.
1.6 × 10⁻⁸. Thus, okay, correct. -8 ampere. This will be the value of current. Okay, copy. So this is first example, current due to translatory motion of charge. Copy. And you know very well how vacuum tube looks like. In the cathode ray experiment, in class 11th chemistry, your teacher told you how cathode ray experiment tube, vacuum tube looks like, right? Where are other students? We started new chapter. What other students are doing, I don't know. Please tell your friends to attend my classes. Okay. Now let's start solving next question. Next question, right heading, due to rotatory motion of charge. Right, current due to rotatory motion of charge. Rotatory or circular? Okay, this is problem number two. Suppose plus Q charge perform circular motion in a circle of radius r with constant speed V. Find current. And it is very important question. This question is very important. Always remember. We need this. This question will come in magnifactor of current again. Okay. Remember, this is very important one. Any suggestion, any clue how to find answer for this question?
Charge not affected by motion.
Charge is not affected by motion. I am talking about current.
Centripetal force is equal to?
No, not required. Centripetal force is also not required. Centripetal force is also not required. Think how current is defined. What is definition of current? Rate of flow of charge. Now see, our next question is based on when charge is given as a function. When charge is given as a function of time, how to find current? When charge is given as function of time. When charge given as function of time, how to find current? Suppose question number 3 says charge is given by t square plus 2t plus 3 coulomb. Find current at t is equal to 3 seconds. How will you solve this question?
Oh, apple pens.
How will you solve this question? Correct. So whenever charge is given in terms of time, always remember, whenever charge is given in terms of time, you will do I is equal to dq by dt. Always remember, all students, please remember, whenever q is given as a function of time, you differentiate with respect to time to get current. Okay, now what we'll get, see. 2t plus 2. Now we will put t is equal to 3 seconds because they want current at 3 seconds, right? So we'll get current is equal to 3 to the 6 plus 2, 8 ampere. Understood? Any doubt in that? Ready for next pattern? Aage bada do?
Okay.
Give me one. Now read this question. 10 to power 6 electrons traveling from right to left and 10 to power 6 proton traveling left to right in 1 microsecond. Find current. Take your time.
Zero.
See, it is very easy because current flows opposite to flow of negative charge and current flow along flow of positive charge. That's why while writing formula, we will add number of electron and number of proton because both of them are going to contribute in the flow of current, right? So we'll take E common and when we'll put value of N, which is equal for electron and proton, we'll get this. And let's solve this. What we will get? 10 to power minus 19, minus 19 plus 12, how much we'll get? Minus 7, right? So 3.2 into 10 to power minus 7 ampere. Is this correct? This is correct, yes, Bachu?
Yes.
Any doubt? Okay, no doubt in that, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So I believe you all are very comfortable till now. No problem at all, anywhere, right? Current. Hopefully everyone understood how current is defined, right? So rate of flow of charge is called current. Let's revise definition again. The rate of flow of charge is called current, and it flows along flow of positive charge. Its unit is ampere. It flows opposite to the flow of negative charge. It always flows from higher potential to lower potential. We represent current by capital I or small I. We did first question based on translatory motion of charge, current due to translatory motion of charge. Second question due to current due to rotatory or circular motion of charge. Third question, in which charge dependent on time, we differentiated charge to get current, right? And in the last question, electron and proton both were traveling simultaneously and we tried finding current, right? Now, as I told you, after understanding basics of current, we'll start resistance. We'll start understanding what is resistance, okay? Now, anyone can define resistance because this topic was there in class 10. Anyone would like to tell me
anything
about the resistance?
Material, property of the material to block the flow of current through it.
Okay, very close, very close. See, bacho.
V is directly proportional to I.
Okay, see how I would like to explain you resistance, what is my way of explaining resistance? See this. Imagine a slope. Imagine a slope like this. Do not focus on the slope. Suppose, imagine yourself as a football. Imagine yourself as a football and start your journey. Start your journey from the top. You will come at the bottom very fast, right? Without any interruption, if surface is very smooth, right? You will come down quickly. No doubt in that. But imagine, what if there are some pillars on the way? Everyone can see a slope, right? Everyone can see a slope. Now imagine yourself as a football and there are some pillars. There are some pillars like this. Not visible, na? Green color, not visible. There are some black color pillars on the way. They are placed randomly. These pillars are placed randomly. Imagine yourself football and come downward. What you are observing? What is your imagination? Tell me, how these pillars are going to affect your motion? Suppose this is you. This football is you. While coming downward, you will collide with this pillar, this. These pillars are helping you in coming downward or making it difficult for you? Come on.
Difficult,
right?
Difficult.
These pillars resisting your downward motion, right? Because of collision. You will be colliding with them and they will make your effective path very big, right? So simply we can define, from my diagram it is clear that we can simply define resistance is total opposition offered to flow of current, okay? What is resistance? Resistance is, it is total opposition. It is total opposition offered to flow of current in the conductor. Always remember this basic definition. This is basic definition of resistance. Okay. Now we represent resistance by R. Its unit is, let's complete all the notes about resistance, okay? We represent resistance by capital R. Its unit is ohm. We represent resistance by capital R. Its unit is ohm. We represent resistance by capital R. Its unit is ohm. Its symbol is a zigzag like this. Symbol of resistance is like this zigzag type. And unit of resistance also have a symbol. Unit of resistance is ohm, and its unit also have a symbol. Unit of resistance is ohm. Is ohm, and its unit has a symbol like this. You did this in class 10th. Hopefully you remember. Do you remember? This is symbol of resistance. This is symbol of unit. This is symbol of resistance, and this is symbol of unit of resistance. Right. Now, suppose you have a conductor whose length is L and area of cross section is A. Okay. Suppose you have a cylindrical conductor. This is a conducting wire. Okay. Area of cross section is A. Area of cross section is A, and its length is suppose L. So resistance of this conductor will depend on what factors? Can you suggest me? Its resistance will depend on what factors?
Current and voltage.
No, resistance of this conductor only alone when current and voltage not applied.
Directly proportional to L, inversely proportional to A.
What is name of this student?
Shreya.
Okay, resistance. So
directly proportional to area.
Resistance is directly proportional to length of conductor. Length of conductor. If sir, length L is more, if length is more, resistance is more. But if length is less, length is small, resistance is small, and it is inversely proportional to area. Resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section. Always remember. Resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section. Okay, suppose length is L and area of cross section is A. Then how we can write how we can write a formula of resistance? See, formula of resistance we can write like this: R is proportional to L, and R is inversely proportional to area. If we combine these two, we can write resistance is proportional to L upon A. Now anyone can tell me what proportionality sign will come?
Rho.
What constant will come if I remove proportionality? Rho. Correct.
Rho.
Anyone please tell me name of rho.
Specific.
What? Specific resistance. Very good. Name of rho is, this is known as specific resistance. Rho is specific resistance, and it's a constant. It's a constant. Where rho is a constant. We'll talk about specific resistance or rho more. And it is also known as resistivity. Rho has two names. It is known as specific resistance as well as resistivity. It has two names. Okay, so it's a constant which depends on type of material and temperature only. Okay, so you can write here where rho is a constant. Where rho is a constant which is known by name resistivity. Speak once. resistivity, okay, which is known by the name resistivity, okay, which depends mainly on type of material and temperature of wire. Rho mainly depends on type of material and temperature of conductor. Okay, rho mainly depends on type of material and temperature of conductor. Rho is independent from dimensions of conductor. Rho is independent from, very important note, rho is independent from dimensions, means size, area and length, dimensions of conductor. Okay, please copy. Rho is independent from dimensions of conductor. So I have one easy problem for you. Suppose we have two copper wires. This copper wire has area A and length L. And suppose we have, this is copper wire. And we have another copper wire whose area is 2A and length is 2L. Suppose its length is 2L. And its area is 2A. So what is resistivity of copper wire? If resistivity of first copper wire is rho, then what is resistivity of second copper wire?
Rho.
Very good. Very good. Because resistivity depends on type of material. It is independent from dimensions. Means length and area will not affect resistivity. Okay? If one wire is copper and another wire is gold, then definitely resistivity will be different. Okay? Always remember. Always remember. Now, we understood a little bit about resistance, right? So finally, we can say that, resistance is equal to rho L upon A, where A is area of cross section. Of wire. Always remember. Now, suppose I have one wire. Of length L and area A. Its area of cross section is A and length is L. And material of wire is suppose copper. Okay, and its resistance is R. Suppose resistance of this wire is R. If I keep nine wires like this, if I keep nine such wires like this, see, if I make bundle of nine such wires like this, then what will be the resistance of this bundle of wire? This is one.
Wait.
First look at how I'm going to arrange all the wires. If I make bundle of nine wires, give me 1 minute. We'll go slowly. This color is very close. We need different color. This color is okay. This is second wire. Total we got three wire already. This is suppose fourth wire. How many wires you can see? Four, right? I'm making bundle of wire. How many wires you can see now?
Five.
Like this, if I keep total nine wires, what will be the resistance of this bundle?
9R.
Okay. Think again, you are wrong.
Rho L by 9A.
Means how many times less?
R by 9.
Correct. What is the name of this girl?
Shreya.
Very good, Shreya. Okay, let's. How many I made already? 5, 6, 7. Two more required. One more required. 8 wires. Which color we can take, bacho? Let's take pink color. Girl's favorite color. Oh, so what is overall area, bacho? What is the overall area of cross section of this bundle of wire?
9A.
Overall area of cross section is 9A. Right. So resistance will become rho L upon 9A. Because length is same, right? That's why a new resistance is 9 times smaller than old resistance. Everyone understood? Any doubt in this? Okay. Okay. Now let's move towards our next example. What our next example is saying? Suppose we have two wires. Area is A, length is R, and its resistance is R. We have another wire of A, so of cross section A and length L. What will be the resistance if I add these two wires like this in series, like this? Wire one, okay, connected with wire two.
Sir, is rho R same?
Ha, rho, same material.
2R.
Twice the initial.
Correct. So you will write rho R dash is equal to rho 2L upon A. So you'll get 2R. Right? Understood? Okay. Now see, read my next question. A wire of resistance R is divided in 3 equal parts. Now these 3 parts are connected in parallel. Like this question, like this. Ek par ek. Okay. Then what is resistance of? Then what is resistance of new?
R by 9.
R by 9. Yes. Answer will be R by 9. How? See, you have one wire. Suppose this is your one wire. Okay. Its area of cross section is A. And length is L. Now you divide this into three equal parts. So part of each length will become, each wire will become L by 3. Right? Am I right? And the second wire all and wire kept like this. Another part kept like this. Another part kept like this. So what is total area? Can you tell me? Is it A or 3A? What is the area of this bundle? 3A. Length of this bundle? L by 3. So according to formula, we'll get rho L by 3 divided by 3A. So we will get R dash is equal to rho L by 9A, right? And if you look at the case one, length was L, R was is equal to rho L upon A. So R is equal to rho L upon A. But we got R dash is equal to rho L upon 9A, means new resistance is 9 times smaller than old resistance. Understood everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now let's write our next topic, stretching of wire. Okay. Now in this case, our old formula will not work. So if you are stretching a wire, its volume is not going to change. When you stretch a wire, its length will increase and area will decrease, but its volume will remain same. The most important point. Second point, the old formula rho L upon A will not work. Will not work at all. You need a new formula. What you can get two formula. You can get two formula in case of stretching of wire. See, suppose you have a wire, you have a cylindrical wire. Can anyone tell me what will be the volume of this wire? Anvit, can you tell me what will be the volume of this wire? A into L, simple. Area.
A into L.
A into L is will be the volume, right? Now I don't want to use this formula. I want to bring volume in that, in this. So it is very easy. You can convert this formula from R is equal to rho L upon A means you can bring volume in the picture anytime. But how? Case one, you multiply and divide by. Case one, you multiply and divide by length. Okay. If you multiply and divide by length, you can see volume. You can bring volume in the picture. See that. This is simple formula of resistance, rho L upon A. And with multiply and divide by length in numerator and denominator. Let's see how it will look like. R is equal to rho L upon A. Let's multiply by length and divide by length. What will get? Rho L square upon A into L. A into L means volume. Okay. So when you are stretching wire, volume will not change. Resistivity will not change. Rho will not change. So resistance will become proportional to square of length. Okay. Now you have one more case. Why you are multiplying divide by L? You can multiply and divide by area also. This option is also there. Am I right, Sreya? Ganesh, am I right? You can multiply and divide by A also.
Yes.
If you multiply and divide
rho by A,
you will get rho, length into area volume, divided by A square. Now, what is A? What is A? A is equal to pi R square, where R is radius of cross section. Okay. Radius, this radius. So let's substitute value of A. What we'll get? You'll get R is equal to rho into volume divided by pi square radius power 4. So you got resistance inversely proportional to radius of wire power 4. You got two important information. Okay. So which formula you liked most? See, numerator is constant. Volume is constant. Resistivity is constant. If we remove constant, we'll get proportionality sign. So you got two results for resistance. Resistance can be proportional to square of length, and resistance can be inversely proportional to radius. Right? Radius power 4. Now, when you will use which formula? Suppose if in the question information about length is given. A wire is stretched and its length become 2 times, its length became 3 times. Which formula you will use? Suppose in quotient, information about length is given. Which formula you will use? Information about only length is given.
R directly proportional to L square.
Only length is given. We will use R is proportional to L square. If information about length is given, we will use this formula. Okay. Suppose if in quotient information about only area is given. If in quotient information about area is given, what you will use? You will use R is inversely proportional to area of a square, right? And if in quotient information about radius is given, stretching of wire, we are doing stretching of wire. Okay. you will apply R is inversely proportional to radius power 4. Okay. So that's it for the day. You will get this lecture in YouTube also.